Yeah, I know. We made this exact video, what is it, like, 3 days ago on Shane Wright? 3 days ago, and I think it's like 11 or something videos ago, so I guess that goes to show how often we upload on this channel or exactly how much free time I have. No, I'm joking about that. This is kind of my full-time job, so of course I'm supposed to dedicate time towards it, but yeah, we made this video about Shane Wright and the Montreal Canadiens earlier on in the week, and it's kind of funny because we're doing the exact same thing about Connor Bedard, who is the guy who is going to be drafted first overall the year after Shane Wright in 2023. Now, don't worry, I'm not pulling this out of thin air, I'm not going out there and just trying to make up rumors to get clicks. I do other things in order to get clicks, like go over on the TVA Sports and look at some of the articles that are being published, like this one. Here's an article translated from French into English. We're gonna read through this today because my goodness, what an article this is. Connor Bedard and the Canadiens. That would be incredible, says his father. And yeah, I know, I kinda had the same reaction that you had when I read that, because it's like, oh, okay, we're doing this again. We're talking about a franchise, potentially generational player, and the Montreal Canadiens again. Last time, it's because Shane Wright said that it would be pretty great to play in Montreal. This time, it's because Connor Bedard's father has gone out there and said the same thing. On December 28th, 16-year-old Connor Bedard became the youngest player in the history of the World Junior Hockey Championship to score 4 goals in a game. We already talked about that, by the way, so go ahead, check out the video we made discussing that feat. But the dynamic right-handed forward put Wayne Gretzky's previous mark of 3 goals against Czechoslovakia in 1977 in his small back pocket, and in the midst of a pandemic, allowed an entire country to celebrate, euphorically, the success of one of its own. It was, however, in a house in Regina, Saskatchewan, that the most loyal supporters of Connor Bedard were to be found at the time, his parents, Thomas and Melanie. When Bedard scored the fourth time, we knew he had just made history. Obviously, the reaction in the house was magical. This is where things get funny. As part of a most generous interview with TVA Sports, Thomas Bedard, Connor's father, agreed to return this evening of December 28th. Without filter, he told how the family had lived the last hours and even trusting, in passing, some crazy superstitions in the household on game days. And the nice man didn't stop there. Know that the Bedard family has a special bond with Quebec, and a great love for the Montreal Canadiens, boy, let's go! Okay, yeah, I don't really care about the ritual stuff. They talk about the superstitions and all the things that they talk about the things that they do on game days, the shirts that the parents wear and whatnot. They talk about the frustration, how Connor Bedard is upset that the World Juniors got canceled and all that, but what we really want to focus on in this article is the part towards the end, the Bedard's special link with Quebec. If you want to go ahead and read this article, their link will be in the description because there is indeed a whole bunch of stuff from Bedard's father and just a few Easter eggs here and there about the Bedard household and what Connor Bedard's psyche is about the game and all that, but this part at the end is why we're even making this video. Which team will Connor Bedard end up with in the NHL? We have to wait until the summer of 2023 to find out, but if it were up to Thomas, the Canadiens would be right at the top of the Bedard family list. Montreal would be incredible. I know it's a place where the pressure is great, but I grew up watching the Habs in the 70s, and it would be fantastic to see Connor land with the Canadiens too. Connor Bedard's father concludes with a statement that is as surprising as it is interesting. 50 years ago, before I was born, the Bedard family was settled in Quebec City. Our clan had since moved to Western Canada. This is where I was born and where Connor was born. I learned this just a few years ago. I definitely want to go back to Quebec someday, so if it was ever for Connor, that would make a lot of sense for our family. In Montreal, many supporters certainly share the same opinion. Okay, let's talk about Connor Bedard in Montreal. You know, I could go out there and just take the Shane Wright video and copy it and paste it and just kind of say the same thing. Although that would be sort of unfair because Shane Wright and Connor Bedard are not the same player. Shane Wright is a little bit bigger, he's a little bit more physical, he's a little bit more, let's just say, polished defensively. But I mean, he is older too, so that's probably not a difficult conclusion to make. But Shane Wright is a little bit more of a sniper, a little bit more of an Austin Matthews kind of, okay, he's just going to take it, grip it, rip it, and he's going to score every time. That's not to say that Connor Bedard doesn't have the skill set to just come and grip it and rip it, but the ways in which Bedard uses his skills are a lot more creative, in my opinion. They're a lot more, okay, what in the world did he just do? Rather than Shane Wright, where it's just a lot more, oh my goodness, what a snipe. Connor Bedard is a smaller player, 16 years old, of course. He's a lot more finesse in his game, in my opinion. He's a lot more deception, and he's a lot more pizzazz and wow. He's smaller, so there is a little bit of a bigger incentive for him to go out there and try to dangle guys a little bit more, try to do some nifty things a little bit more. And the funny thing is, whenever Connor Bedard goes out there and tries a nifty little toe drag to get around a D-man to open up a passing lane in front, or he does a fancy move to go around a guy and then backhand it up high on the goaltender with such ease, he usually does these things at such a high percentage of success that it's like, okay, first off, he has the mindset to be willing to do this stuff, this crazy, out-of-the-box type stuff that makes him so surprising for opponents, but his success rate is so high because he's so skilled that he's a lot more of a precise playmaker, just dangle the pants off of you and then snipe it home kind of guy, whereas Shane Wright is just a more polished goal scorer in every sense of the word. I'd say Connor Bedard is a lot more like a Crosby-McDavid hybrid than he is a Matthews, and Shane Wright is a lot more of that Matthews label. But of course, I don't want to go out there and say that 17, 16-year-old guys are going to be the next incarnations of McDavid, Crosby, and Matthews. It's just stylistically, you know, if I had to say they play like a certain player, Bedard is more like that Kucherov blend too. Now, is he going to dominate the game with his speed like Connor McDavid does today? I don't know. That's a difficult question to answer because nobody at 16 years old can really project a being McDavid, but there are similarities in the lethality of a Kucherov and the precision of a Crosby and the ability to dangle guys at top speeds like McDavid that Connor Bedard plays into his game so well. And I'm not just pumping his tires because he's a guy from North Van over here, or excuse me, West Van, and he's technically a Vancouver Canucks fan. His favorite Canuck is Tyler Motte, which is great for Canucks fans to see. But there is such a legitimate profile here for Connor Bedard that, yeah, you want to talk about the Montreal Canadiens and Nick Suzuki? If Nick Suzuki takes on a more defensively responsible role and still keeps the playmaking offensive touch that he has, then I said this in the Shane Wright video, but having a 1-2 punch of Bedard-Suzuki could be phenomenal heading into the long-term future. Now, whether or not you would rather have Shane Wright is up to you. Tell me in the comments if you had to choose one for Montreal heading into the long-term future. Suzuki, or excuse me, not Suzuki. They already have Suzuki. Wright or Bedard. Let me know who it is you would like to see head onto this team long-term. But for Connor Bedard and his family, it's very apparent that the Canadiens would be a prime destination as well. So for Connor Bedard, I mean, if his dad is in the corner of the Montreal Canadiens, and I guess it's a lot easier for me and you and other people to go out there and kind of feel the same way. So, yeah, Connor Bedard to Montreal, eh? Guess the Canadiens have to still suck next year in order for that to happen, or they just have to get really lucky in the draft lottery because that's still going to be a thing by the time the 23 draft rolls around, right? Is it going to be? I don't know. And even if it's not, then they could still be bad and they could still get Matvei Mishkov, who won't go to the NHL till his mid-20s, I think. But there still are some very, very good prospects available afterwards. So, Connor Bedard, let me know in the comments all your thoughts about him and the Canadiens, whether or not he would fit here in Montreal. Obviously, small centers with really good skill sets. Small forwards in general have had records and records and history here in Montreal. You talk about the Richard brothers, you talk about, obviously, Bernie, Boom Boom, you talk about the guys on the team now, Gallagher, Byron, of course, Suzuki is in there, who isn't really the biggest guy in the world, but he's still kind of there, and then Cole Caulfield, who is just kind of, yeah, I think we have to make a video about Caulfield as well. Not a good one this time. So, talk to me in the comments, what do you think about Connor Bedard and everything that he has done? Montreal Canadiens, yay or nay? I hope you enjoyed this bit of Rosén 99. And bye.